Hi, I'm Palab. I'm one of the subject matter experts here at Chegg. You may have already learned about demand-supply elasticity, but what does it actually look like in application? Suppose a good exhibits perfectly elastic demand. That means consumers are extremely influenced by price. If two firms sell it at the same price, any attempts by one firm to increase revenue by raising the price ultimately reverses its competitor, because consumer demand for that product is perfectly elastic. In general, the flatter demand elasticity is, the harder it is to increase prices to increase revenue. This can occur when markets are efficient and the products between one firm and another are substitutable. Conversely, steeper demand curves make it easier for a firm to raise prices and increase revenue. Initially, firms have a total revenue of P times Q. If demand is inelastic, an increase in prices can increase total revenue to P prime times Q. Goods are rarely perfectly inelastic in a competitive market. However, if a product has only a limited number of producers, consumers may have a steeper demand elasticity curve since there are no ready substitutes. That makes it easier for firms to raise prices to increase revenue. Put simply, when the demand elasticity curve is flat, consumers are extremely sensitive to price, and firms are price takers. When the demand curve is elastic and more vertical, consumers are insensitive to price, and firms can be price makers. Taxes can be seen as additional cost levied on a certain product, where the burden can be shared by producers and consumers. This burden may be split unequally, depending on the demand and supply elasticity of a product. Recall that in a typical environment, the demand and supply curve intersect at price P, and the amount supplied and demanded is quantity Q. This generates consumer and producer surplus, which is the benefit of making an economic transaction. Now, let's introduce a tax. Price increases from P to PT for consumers, and the prices received by producers falls from P to PS. Quantity demanded and supplied falls from Q to QT. Two new concepts are introduced. First, the tax revenue, represented by the shaded gray box, shows the amount of revenue the government receives as a result of the tax. The tax also results in a deadweight loss, the shaded triangle, which is the cost to society from an inefficient supply and demand environment. Consumer surplus is reduced by the area Q star, PT minus P, and the producer surplus is reduced by Q star, P minus PS, as a result of the tax. Note that since supply and demand have similar slopes, the reductions in producer and consumer surplus are similar. But in an environment where the demand curve is more inelastic, consumers bear more of the tax burden through a loss of a consumer surplus. Say, the demand elastic curve D moves to a more elastic D prime. The same increase in price from P to PT results in a much smaller consumer surplus than it would have without the tax. Note that the share of tax burden by consumers is also larger than the share burden by producers, and the deadweight loss area is larger. In general, whichever side of the demand or supply equilibrium is more inelastic will bear more of the cost associated with the tax. So far, we looked at goods where demand increases with increase in income, also known as normal goods. Normal goods exhibit a downward sloping demand curve. However, there are some products where demand increases with the price, where the demand curve slopes upward. These goods are called Veblen goods. Real-life examples of Veblen goods can be found in the luxury market, like high-end watches, cars, or art, where the demand increases the higher it is priced. Thanks for watching, and remember to come visit us at Chegg, where you can ask for help directly from one of the Chegg subject matter experts.